Hey guys, it's Elise. Welcome back to another video. This was the video that won the poll that I posted on Friday. This tutorial is very overdue. This song has been out for a good while now. Anyways, I have narrowed this song down to 5 chords. Be looking out for my cover of this song. A couple things that I wanted to say before we get into learning this song. I have been posting on TikTok more. I will go ahead and put my TikTok down in the description if you wanted to follow. Also, if you want to buy anything from donnerdeal.com, remember I do have an affiliate link to help me out. That would help you save some money. Keyboards, guitars, accessories, microphones, pretty much anything that you would need. And if this tutorial helps you, go ahead and check out my other tutorials. Now I think I've talked enough. Let's get into learning Happier Than Ever by Billie Eilish. If you're new here, just ignore my disgusting piano keys. I can't get this tape off to save my life. Now let's just do a quick run through of what we're gonna be learning. I am only gonna do the intro, but then I'll dive more into the rest when we learn it. When I'm away from you, I'm happier than ever. Wish I could explain it better. I wish it wasn't true. Give me a day or two to think of something clever. Now let's go ahead and dive in and learn what these chords are. So for the intro, you're going to be using 5 chords, and then the 6th chord doesn't come in until the pre-chorus. So anyways, the first chord that we're going to learn is a C major that consists of C, E, and G. Okay, the next chord is an E major, which is E, G sharp, and B. Go down and do A minor, A, C, and E. Okay, next we're going to go back to the right and do F major, F, A, C. And then the 5th chord that we're gonna learn right now is a G major inversion. And I know that sounds a little intimidating, so let me kind of break down what that means. So the G major chord that everybody is so familiar with consists of G, B, and D, right? So what an inversion means is pretty much we're just gonna change the order that we play those notes. So the chord that we're gonna use for this song is D, G, and B. So we pretty much just took the G major chord, inverted the way that we play the notes, and we got this chord. So anyways, now let's go ahead and learn the last chord that we're gonna have to learn, which consists of C, F, and G sharp. And like I said, we're only gonna use that in the pre-chorus. Okay, so now let's go ahead and learn how to play these chords. So as you can see in my little run through, we're just gonna play each of these chords once. When I'm away from you, I'm happier than ever. Wish I could explain it better. I wish it wasn't true. Give me a day or two to think of something clever, to write myself a letter, to tell me what to do. Okay, so now we go into the pre-chorus. So that is going to consist of C major, E major, A minor, and then the last chord that we learned, C, F, G sharp. Okay, so now we play those 4 together. this is how that goes with words.
Do you read my interviews, or do you skip my avenue when you said you were passing through? Was I even on your way? And I know when I asked you to be cool about what I was telling you, you do the opposite of what you said you'd do, and I'd end up more afraid.
Okay, then there's just like a little section before she goes back into the intro and then transitions into the chorus. Okay, and for this little part, it's gonna be E major. Then we're gonna go right on over to the D major inversion, and then C major. Okay, and that part goes like this.
Don't say it isn't fair, you really weren't aware that you made me miserable.
Okay, and back into the intro.
When I'm away from you, happier than ever. Wish I could explain it better. I wish it wasn't true.
Sorry.
True.
Okay. It's the same thing that we learned before. And now when we're going into the last part of the song, it's going to get a little more intense because we're going to add a bass note. So we're still going to take our four chords that we had in the beginning, C major, E major, A minor, F major, but now we're going to add a bass note, and that bass note is going to be whatever our right hand thumb is on. So when we play C major, our bass note is going to be C. Okay, when we play E major, our bass note is going to be E. We play A minor, our bass note is going to be A, and then F major, our bass note is going to be F. So in this last little part, our bass note we're going to play 12 times, so that's what this is going to sound like.
1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6
And on this hand, we're going to play each chord twice. So it's going to sound like this.
1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4
Okay, so now if we add those two together, and we're going to do it very slowly, so don't get intimidated by this part. If you did not want to play each chord 12 times, or if you didn't want to play each bass note 12 times, that's completely up to you, and that would be perfectly fine. But this just mimics kind of what her instrumental does in the song, and gives it kind of a deeper emotional aspect, if that makes sense. So now let's go ahead and play the bass note with the right hand chord. To go over that more, feel free to rewind and practice that as many times as you need. Okay, so that little part that we just did has no words, so then we're going to do the same exact thing when she starts singing. So let me do it one more time, kind of how you would play it in the song. Okay, so we're coming off of
I wish it wasn't true.
Thank you.
treat me this shitty. You made me hate this city. And I don't talk.
Okay, we're gonna end right there. And I don't talk. And then we're gonna go back to C major. But now we're just gonna play the bass note and the chord on your right hand two times. So it's gonna sound like this. How you're gonna end the song. So if we're coming off of,
I don't talk shit about you on the internet, never told anyone anything bad, cause that shit's embarrassing, and you were my everything, and all you ever did was make me fucking sad. Don't waste the time I don't have. Don't try to make me feel bad. I could talk about all the times that you showed up on time, but I'd have an empty line, cause you never did. And never paid any mind to my mother or friends, so I cut them all off for you, cause I was a kid. You ruined everything good.
Okay, good job. You learned the whole song. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to drop a timestamp down in the comments of where you're confused about, because I know sometimes I go a little too fast or a little too slow to where it doesn't even make any sense. Yeah, like I said in the beginning, if this tutorial helped you, go ahead and check out my other piano tutorials. I hope this helped, and I'll see you next video.